We are talking about democracy around the world as the best form of government. And 1.2 billion people are affected by 70% of the resolutions of the General Assembly and most of the decisions of the Security Council. I think it is hypocritical to not let Africa have a fair representation within a body that fairly deals with them. So I am advocating for two permanencies within the Security Council, the permanent part of the Security Council, and to make sure that we take part in the discussions that lead to resolutions and also decisions that affect Africa.
And when you say 1.2 billion, you're referring to the population of Africa. But is the position of the African Union that Africa is subjugated then at the UN Security Council?
Correct. We feel that this is part of the historical discrimination and also injustice that has been inflicted on Africa for a very long time.
But are not African leaders and communicators the architects of our own subjugation? I mean, we're only bystanders in world affairs because we choose to be. Is that not so?
Well, we've chosen not to be anymore. That's why we're asking for a key position. We want to be heard. We don't just want to be seen at the UN. We want to be heard, especially in the decisions that affect the world, because we are also part of the world.
But for example, I mean, you say to be seen, not to be silent. But for example, when a big story breaks, we journalists in the foreign media find it so hard to get an African leader to comment. A natural disaster happens, like last year in your country, the mudslide. The world's media clamours for coverage, and the African Union's phone number remains unanswered. So isn't that an example of us being architects of our own subjugation?
Well, we have a new crop of leaders in Africa. I represent that new crop. I'm not going to shy away from critical issues in Africa. I am always ready to respond from my own perspective. And that is why, in as much as I spoke about issues concerning Sierra Leone and the world in general, I support the move for reform of the UN and also conflict prevention and peace and security, the SDGs, all of that I spoke about. But I think that there is something more important to us in Africa. And I'm not going to shy away from that, however controversial it might sound.
But in Africa, aren't African leaders like yourself overly focused on conflict prevention, but only in Africa? Sustainable development goals, but only in Africa? What happened to that crop of African leaders who said it's also our place to comment on world affairs? So when something happens in Yemen, in Syria or Indonesia, you're ready to talk, ready to give an opinion that becomes valued. Whereas today, we don't hear. We hear very few African leaders commenting on anything outside problems that are very local to Africa in the world's perception.
Well, I think I'm only 5 months in office. Quite a lot of our leaders have been tamed to believe that we don't have a voice in the world. However, I mean, minute that might be or irrelevant that might be, I think we have to make the comment. But I hold the view that we are lacking behind in development and a lot of other issues. I want to concentrate first on making my country, my continent, a better place. And then maybe we live in a world where only the rich are listened to. So if we are able to stop begging for money and other things, if we can take care of ourselves, then we will have a voice that is forceful, that can be listened to and heeded in terms of when we give warning about certain things. But I think if you go cap in hand all the time begging for even your mere existence, nobody's going to want to listen to your perspective. You may say it because you have a podium. But I believe that when countries that matter are going to talk, people want to listen to them. So I would still advise us to, in as much as we want to comment on world issues, that we comment or work very hard to make ourselves relevant actors on the world stage. And then when we talk, people will listen to us.